Welcome to Inset Data Bytes. Data Bytes is a weekly newsletter that brings to you best hand-picked solutions and stories from all across the world in the field of data science, ML and AI. In this week's edition of Data Bytes, here are our top 5 stories. Make sure to check out the links in description so that you get the full scoop of every feature.
Welcome to 20th August 2020 video newsletter edition of Data Bytes. This week we are going to focus on ML-based stories only. And the first story that we have for you is 5 reasons why machine learning will boost your career. So before we get started with our machine learning stories, the best question to address is, why should you be learning machine learning, or why should you be excited about machine learning? As you know, there has been a 400% increase in the demand of data science and machine learning based roles over the years. And why not so? Because it is estimated by 2022, 30 to 35% of decisions made by consumers when it comes to what do they want to eat, where do they want to live, or what do they want to wear is going to be based on machine learning based suggestions. And a lot of jobs would be created in this sector. Subsequently, around 133 million new jobs are expected to be introduced in the sector of machine learning across industries, and which is why this is a very hot field right now. So what you must do is that you must start thinking of making a career in machine learning and getting yourself prepared for all you need to be aware of if you are looking at a career in machine learning. The next story that we have for you is profiling the ideal machine learning student. So once you've taken the decision that you are, that you're willing to move to this field of machine learning, the first thing that you have to do is ask yourself if you have the aptitude to become a machine learning engineer, because it's all the job is very hyped and there are a lot of rewarding opportunities in this sphere as well, but you must not do it if you are not in for the hard work that it entails. So what we've done is we've created another feature for you where you can understand the different skill sets that are needed to become a machine learning engineer or a machine learning researcher or a machine learning scientist. And also we are bursting some bubbles as to what has been hyped and what is actually real. We have a small ML aptitude test for you as well. If you find most of the answers are yes, and these are some areas that you're willing to work upon, then ML is the course that your career should take. The third article that we have for you today is Data Security, a Machine Learning Perspective. Now, this feature has been written by Dr. Chitra Desai, who was one of our budding Data Science Leader Award winner last year in 2019. Dr. Chitra Desai is actively involved in academia, and which is why this article is a very smooth read as well when it comes to reading it as a, from a reader's perspective. What the topic that she has taken up is data security, which has become becoming an elephantine challenge as more data is being discovered, unearthed and analyzed every day. Now, she introduces the concept of cryptology in this article, which is how to make your data cryptic for others to read and protect your data from any kind of security breach that might be out there. So this is very important and very relevant also when it comes from a security point of view. Spotlight story that we have for you is Prasad from DBX Cento Systems. Prasad is a software engineer who was part of the GCD July 2019 batch. And this article discusses, or this interview talks about how Prasad managed to wade his way through his career and through his job and through the data science course at INSET, and how has he now, with the help of his mentors, projected himself as a better data scientist over time. The last story that we have for you is, what are machine learning projects? So if you remember, a couple of weeks back, we discussed the kind of projects that you should be undertaking and the data sets for these projects. If you haven't checked out those stories, make sure that you check out stories from the last week of July. That's when we covered these topics. Now that you know that what kind of projects you should be looking out for and where exactly would you find the data set, relevant data set for these projects, this feature story will tell you about what should be your go-to when you're developing a plan for machine learning projects? What are the different steps involved, and what are the different tools that you can use to get not only to complete your project, but also to test and validate your projects and to check the accuracy of these projects. So make sure that you, before you start a project on data science, make sure that you go through all these different steps and you know exactly what you have to do, when you have to do, so that you cut down on a lot of time when it comes to developing an end-to-end machine learning model or working on a project. And also be totally, totally reassured that we will help you out. If you face any difficulties, just write to admissions at insight.co and we'll answer all your queries there. These were all the stories that we have for you this week. We'll be back next week with more stories for our newsletter. Until then, stay tuned.